The next paper presentation of Osmicon 2014 sponsored by NECC and Safala Oats is by Anahat Kaur. The topic is evaluation of self-awareness of diabetes management in patients with clinically evident diabetic retinopathy.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Anahat Kaur, and I'm here to present a paper on evaluation of self-awareness of diabetes management in patients with clinically evident diabetic retinopathy. Diabetic retinopathy is one of the leading causes of vision loss worldwide. The number of patients with diabetes is expected to be 366 million by 2030. And according to WHO, India leads the world with over 32 million diabetic patients. The major complications of diabetes, most of these do not manifest until after years of suboptimal control. Hence, many patients do not see any immediate benefit of strict blood sugar control, and they generally regard it as an inconvenience or an unachievable goal. So better patient awareness and involvement of the healthcare personnel in the management of diabetes will help increase the treatment compliance and also improve the overall diabetic control. Multiple trials such as the Diabetes Control and Complications Trial and the UK Prospective Diabetes Study have demonstrated the benefits of long-term diabetes control, and all these trials have recommended using HbA1c as a measure of glycemic control. Results from these trials prompted the American Diabetes Association to recommend a goal of HbA1c less than 7% in diabetic patients. Most of our patient population today is unaware of the manifestations, the risk factors, and management of diabetes. But as this disease progresses and complications develop, patients are more likely to grasp the importance of treatment compliance. So based on this rationale, we hypothesized that patients with non-vision-threatening diabetic retinopathy are less likely to be aware of diabetes complications as compared to those with diabetes-related vision loss. To test our hypothesis, we designed the study, which was a cross-sectional study involving diabetic patients undergoing dilated fundus examination in our tertiary care institution. The overall aim of this study was to promote patient education and involvement in the management of their diabetes. The specific objective was to assess the level of diabetes awareness in patients with diabetes presenting to the ophthalmology OPD. The inclusion criteria for this study were patients with diabetes who undergo a dilated fundus examination at the ophthalmology OPD, willingness to participate, and age more than 18 years. Exclusion criteria included unwillingness to participate and an inconclusive history of diabetes mellitus. The details of the patients were recorded in a patient performer. Best corrected visual acuity and level of retinopathy as seen on fundoscopic examination were noted. A questionnaire was given to all the patients to assess their level of diabetes awareness. After collecting the questionnaires, the data was analyzed to establish a correlation between the patient response and level of vision and retinopathy. Statistical tools were used to test for statistical significance, and a p-value of less than 0.05 was considered statistically significant. We evaluated 100 patients of diabetes mellitus undergoing a dilated fundus examination at the ophthalmology OPD of our tertiary care institution during a recruitment period of 2 months. After conducting the initial evaluation, some of the patients were excluded because of a yet unconfirmed diagnosis of diabetes, and in the end, 73 patients were selected for this study. All 73 patients reported having received diabetes education in the past, but only 48 of these knew the risks and complications of diabetes mellitus. 94% patients were aware of the signs and symptoms of the disease. 91% patients knew the importance of diet control, and 63% were aware of the need for regular exercise. However, 39.7% patients admitted to non-compliance with diabetes medication. We all know that regular monitoring of HbA1c is very important for the long-term management of diabetes mellitus. However, only 5 patients in our study knew what HbA1c was. But 62 of them reported the correct range for normal blood sugar levels. As I have just mentioned, today the main parameter for assessment of diabetes according to the American Diabetes Association is HbA1c and not FBS. 18 patients in our study had HbA1c tested in the recent past, but only 4 of these 18 knew that HbA1c represents glycemic control over the past 3 months. The patients who had been tested for HbA1c were more likely to know about its relevance. Longer duration of diabetes was seen to be associated with a better understanding of the disease, specifically when the duration was more than 10 years. However, presence of vision changes did not predict a higher level of awareness. No statistical difference was seen in medication compliance and patient education between patients who had vision less than 6x24 and those with visual acuity 6x24 or better. Our results rejected the initial hypothesis that patients with vision loss due to diabetic retinopathy would be more aware of their disease and more invested in the treatment of diabetes. Vision loss seemed to have no bearing on the level of patient education, and overall the patient understanding of diabetes was inadequate and dismal. HbA1c levels should be tested every 3 to 4 months since these provide an excellent measure of glycemic control. Our patient population today is at risk for inadequate long-term diabetes management and disabling complications due to the lack of generalized awareness. This study provided us an excellent opportunity for enhancing patient awareness regarding the manifestations and complications of diabetes, and also helped improve treatment compliance. Public health initiatives should be aimed at improving patient awareness and increasing patient education regarding chronic diseases at grassroots levels. Thank you. Are there any questions?
And in 18 years age group, how many people do you have? 18 years.
So, over here I am saying that those patients in whom
you answer my question. Pardon? See, 18 years group, because minimum age of the entry in the study is 18 years. How many people of 18 years are there in your study?
How many patients of 18 years?
Yes.
So there's hardly one or two patients who are 18 years of age. Mostly patients were middle-aged or they were elderly patients who had diabetes for around 10 years or more than 10 years.
So that is why incidence, see, age is also is important. Age range, between what range of the year, and one is the duration and the age. That would have been stressed upon.
The importance of age is
it
there.
It is directly related to the control of the glycemia, HbA1c levels and average blood sugar, as well as the duration. Isn't
naturally, but according to this study, generally also the duration of diabetes would lead to microvascular complications. If duration is 10 years or more, if it is 30 years, then microvascular complications would definitely be there. And a patient
because I wanted to know, was there any significant findings of the diabetic retinopathy in that particular age group? Because the duration is very small.
So we've had some patients in this study who were diabetic, but they did not have diabetic retinopathy when they were investigated. So those patients constituted of the group with early diabetes, and we checked their awareness as well.
Yeah, fine. Now one or two observations from the study is that you had a very high rate, high exclusion rate. You said you selected 100 patients with diabetes who were coming to you for diabetes evaluation of their eyes because of diabetes. And 23 of them you excluded. 23 of them you excluded because of uncertain diagnosis of diabetes. If you had said that they were not willing to participate, that's a different issue. But there were 23 with uncertain diagnosis, so there's a disparity there.
These 23. See, a patient who was suspected to have diabetes were coming with all the signs symptoms to the medicine OPD. They were sent to the ophthalmology OPD for fundus examination. So these 23 patients.
Department would be sending only patients who are known to have diabetes, who are being treated for diabetes, for evaluation for diabetic retinopathy. They don't send.
Let me finish.
What I'm saying is that the diagnosis of diabetes is not confirmed by presence of retinopathy. So that's one issue. Second is that your conclusion. I mean, what conclusion are you making from this?
Pardon me, sir.
What is the purpose of the study? Why did you conduct this study?
What is?
What was the main purpose of behind this conducting this study?
What was the main purpose of conducting the study? So the main purpose was, number one, to evaluate that whether the patients who are suffering such a serious complication of diabetes, such as vision loss, are they even aware of their disease? Do they know the complications, further complications? Do they know about HbA1c, which is one of the most important indices?
Right. Okay. That should have come out in the conclusion that, even in spite of having diabetic retinopathy, or even those who are losing sight because of retinopathy, we are not educated.
They are not aware of their disease. That is the sad part. And another purpose was to counsel these patients to increase their awareness regarding diabetes, regarding various investigations, further treatment compliance and complications.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.